Welcome to Brains Matter, the podcast on science, curiosities, and general knowledge. I'm your host, just an ordinary guy. Hello everyone, and welcome to episode 69 of Brains Matter. This is going to be a shorter episode, but hopefully you'll find it topical, given the Olympics are on right now. I hope you enjoyed last week's show, which was a bit of a fun episode, and it was fun to do as well. Did Mark and I cover your favourite fictional scientist? If not, then write in and let Mark and I know who we missed out on. Kath wrote on the Brains Matter website and said, "It sounds like fiction means TV and movies because I'd have to vote for Vic Hunt in the Gentle Giant series by James P. Hogan. And for Wrinkle in Time fans, Meg's father, eventual husband, Calvin O'Keefe and her son Adam are all scientists, though we don't know too much about Dr. Murray. Does Bill Nye the Science Guy count as fictional?" Well, you've got some great suggestions there, Kath. As for Bill Nye, I'm not sure. Being Australian, I'm not exposed to his TV show, so perhaps another listener can answer that for me. Steve wrote in and said, "I support Hayward Floyd in 2001. After all, Arthur C. did pass into the annals of legendary sci-fi authors this year. Well, Arthur." Agreed there, Steve. Richard Jeffries from the US wrote in and said, "Show 68 was excellent. Really enjoyed it." Thanks, Richard. I'm glad you did enjoy it. Alan wrote in about the interview with Pamela Gay on the Milky Way spiral arms and said, "What a great episode. Really enjoyed it. I love the fact that the arms have gone and Dr. Gay explained it so well. Thanks again from a regular." Well, thanks for that, Alan. Glad you enjoyed the interview, and I hope you've enjoyed the others as well. This week is actually Science Week in Australia, so try and get out there and learn some new science, or visit your local science museum, but listen to or watch some science shows, or if you can't do anything else, listen to the back catalogue of Brains Matter. On to today's topic, and that's one related to something that's happening right now, the Olympics. We've all heard of Michael Phelps' great achievements in the pool. As of the moment, although that's probably likely to change with future events, Phelps has 10 Olympic gold medals, more than Mark Spitz, more than any other Olympian in history, and he's been lauded as the greatest Olympian ever. Is that so? Let's look at this from a mathematical and logical perspective. Swimmers actually have a great advantage, and that is that they can compete in multiple events, and because of marketing, the number of swimming events has dramatically increased over the years, so it would actually be unfair to compare a swimmer of today to a swimmer of, say, 50 years ago. There's no doubt that Phelps is an amazing athlete and possibly the best swimmer in history. Sorry, Mark Spitz, Kieran Perkins, and so on. But is it fair to use the number of gold medals as a measuring stick? Let's have a think about this. How about hockey players? With all the games they play, they can only walk out of the Olympics with one gold medal. Same with the football players. Oh, and for those who are in North America, that translates to field hockey and soccer for you guys. I only started watching the Olympics in 1984 or 1988, when I was a bit younger, but I still think the achievements of Carl Lewis are amazing. He was in three or four Olympics, won medals in all of them. Does that mean he's less of an athlete than Phelps? I think you could have a long dinner conversation about that one. What would make someone a great Olympian? Number of gold medals is patently not a level playing field. Have a think about it from a logical and scientific perspective. Is it number of Olympics where you've achieved a medal? What do you think? Drop me a line and let me know. I did say this was going to be a short show, and it is, so I'll leave that quandary for you to consider and get back to me on. In the meantime, I'll leave you with a quote from Scott Adams. "Frankly, I'm suspicious of anyone who has a strong opinion on a complicated issue." Bye for now. Thanks for listening to the show. You can check out the Brains Matter website at www.brainsmatter.com. That's www.brainsmatter.com. And you can find all the other episodes of the show there. Just click on the podcast link on the right-hand side. You can listen to the episodes from your browser by choosing Flash Player from the links and selecting whichever episode you want to hear from within the player. There's also other information on the site, such as links to articles and news, subscription details, both via iTunes and manually, and voting information. Please vote for the podcast on Podcast Alley, and remember to vote every month, since the votes reset at the start of each month. If you want to support the show, have a look at the Support the Show link. You can make a donation via PayPal, or you can buy a book through one of the Amazon links on the support page. If you have any comments or suggestions, you can leave an entry on this episode's show notes on the webpage, or you can send me an email. All my contact information can be found on the site. The theme music Future is performed by Cut Copy and comes courtesy of Glen Goetz from Modular Records. I hope you enjoyed the show. Bye for now.